kucheki. Anipenda ye nimemwacha nyumbani, ye hajui. Baby wanichanganya zingua.
We are here with Vicky and Jean, part of KCA coaching staff. Can you guys give us what your experiences have been coaching KCA as you as ladies? How is it?
The experience has actually been quite nice. They respect us, you know, and it's actually fun because they actually listen to us, and it's actually a good experience because we're learning so much. We get to, you know, practice what we've been learning. Our mentor is Shamia. Shamia is from KCB. So he helps us, you know, when you have questions we ask, and it's good because it's interactive. So like even if you're not sure, you know, you can work with them, you know. So it's been amazing.
And for you?
For me, this particular event has actually been really fun. KCA is still a growing team and everything, but they're actually quick learners, they're ready to learn, so it makes our experience as coaches amazing.
And how did you guys get into coaching? Is there an aha moment that was there that you decided, let me get into coaching?
Personally, I was recruited by Shamia. Shamia, and I didn't even know that he was referring to SNC coaching, but I decided to take the challenge. I love challenges. So and I started learning quite a few things. So like even just as a player, whatever I'm learning as a SNC is helping so much, and I'm also getting to help other people. So I was recruited. And it's amazing.
And for you?
For me, same, but in like a different sense, because I was a sprinter before. So I was meant to help her with like speed and agility drills, so that's what pretty much I do. Like she does the conditioning and then I help with speed. So Shami actually talks to me to come and help her with speed and everything.
Okay, and you ladies, you're part of what's growing, a growing part of women's rugby that's still on its, let's say, birth phase, or let's say is on its growth phase. How has women's rugby been, and what do you think needs to be done for women's rugby?
Rugby for the women's side is actually amazing when we actually have the tournaments, because then you get to see people showcase their talents, and women can actually really play good rugby. The only problem comes in when the season ends, so people go on break and they forget to prepare for the next season. So like now we're supposed to be going for the seventh season, but teams haven't yet like prepared, and so it becomes a challenge, especially for numbers is the main challenge, and maybe motivation, because if you compare the women's rugby to men's rugby, it's not as fun, it's not funded, it's not sponsored, like it's very rare to find, you know, at least full scholarships or full sponsorship. So the only thing I'd ask is that people actually come out and, you know, sponsor, because if they actually sponsor us, it would go a really long way in helping us, you know, become better, because the confidence and the inspiration would really help.
And for you, Jean?
For me, a lot has to be done for women's rugby. Firstly, like I feel like, in my opinion, it's just my personal opinion, but like the union actually has to take time to figure out different talents. Like they have small tournaments for people in school, but then when it comes to the big stage, it's not really like, how do I say it? Like they don't really show much. Like they don't really want to expose women a lot. You know, so every little chance we get, we actually use it to our advantage, because for us, for like the guys rugby, guys rugby in Kenya is known worldwide, but for women here in Kenya it's really not. So we pretty much just play because like heart.
You see the passion. And what do you think that needs to be done for women to be more participatory in terms of just bringing more women into the game? Because it also builds onto what you guys want in terms of just having a bigger depth. So how would you encourage more women to get to do what you're doing? Because it is a good sport. And what should you tell other ladies who are out there and they will be not kind of like shy towards adopting rugby as a sport. What does rugby offer for you guys?
Personally, rugby has changed my life in so many ways, because not only do you become fitter, but also like it works on your mental health. It really does help a lot, and I think I'd urge so many women to try it out, because rugby is one sport that doesn't discriminate. You can be tall, you can be short, you can be big, you can be small, like it doesn't discriminate. You just come and you'll always find a position to play. And at the end of the day, you gain so much, so much. You gain friends, you gain mental stability, like there's so much you can get from rugby. So I think I just, that's what I'd tell them, because also for many, I've heard that there's some people actually want to sponsor the women's rugby, but it's hard when people actually don't come out to show that they actually want to play rugby. So I think when you come out and you actually show the effort and they actually see the talent that's there, then there's a higher chance that you actually get more sponsors. So people should just come out and train first, and then I think definitely it will go a long way in, you know, helping us, at least even if not in the same, when you get on the same platform as the guys, at least in time we're going to grow.
For Eugene?
For me, I'd actually start by saying the same. Like, rugby has also changed my life in so many different ways, because it shapes your mental. Like, it helps you become self-confident. It helps you become stronger. Because for me personally, I can't compare how I am right now compared to how I was as a sprinter. Like, it really does. Like, it makes you believe in yourself. Because if you really don't believe in yourself in the pitch, no one will, you know? But for women's rugby, I feel like motivation is what many girls need, actually. Like, if you actually know, for example, the guys have huge motivations, yeah? Like, making Kenya 15s, making Kenya 7s. Like, that, if you ask many rugby players, that's what they want. But for women, it's like, when they are asked, why are you playing for heart? Because they know, like, they rarely call up new people for Kenya 7s, for women's. So even if you train as hard or work as hard, like, there's no, that you might not get called. So I think that's in the mental for many women. That's why they don't try as hard, or maybe that's why they don't come out. But I feel like maybe Kenya Rugby Union should change that and give opportunities to, like, other people for training. Even if it's just training, not tour, but just training.
Okay. And for you, you talked about Kenya 7s, Kenya 15s. For you personally, as KC and Jane, where's the progression for you rugby? Where do you see your rugby careers going? Or where would you want to be, let's say, 2-1 year down the line?
I think, of course, one day I'd like to join the national team. So maybe the 7s or even the 15s team, that would be amazing. So yeah, I think that's what I'm working towards. But for now, I think I try to keep my goals basically focused on what I'm not trying to play rugby. Yes, I want to join the national team, yes, but I'm not playing rugby. Like me doing all this training, I'm not playing rugby to get there. I'm playing to get to the national team. I'm playing to become better, and if I actually get to go to the national team, then it's amazing. Of course, like, I'd love to actually go and showcase what I've learned, and that would be nice, the experience, you know, meeting with other people, so many opportunities. But I think personally for me, I'd say me, whatever I'm playing right now is purely like out of passion and out of love for rugby. So if I actually get called up for the national team, it's just a bonus for me. So playing rugby by itself is already something. I'm humbled. I'm really humbled.
And for you?
For me, I can already say I'm amazing. I'm very good at what I do. Like, I'm amazing. But 1 year down the line, I feel like I'd be better than Portia Woodman, you know? So I think that's my goal 1 year down. But purely, even for me, I do it for passion. I don't do it because I want to get called up or anything. Because it's not realistic, to be honest. You have to also have passion in it. So for me, it's just for heart, like, to, yeah, better myself, beach body, very many things.
Beach maninos. Okay. And for you guys, let's say, what do you guys do, let's say, on the side apart from rugby? Or rugby is me. What's your main from the side?
I'm a student at USIU. I'm doing computer science. And also, other than the SNC coach, the jobs I've done, actually, like most of the things I'm doing right now are actually connected to rugby. So other than the SNCing, and I'm also a coach for Minitag Rugby, for King's Rugby Development Academy. And also, me and her just started, we're starting a fitness thing, yeah, for personal training. So people should actually go check it out. It's going to come out soon. We're going to start posting workouts for people who want to be fit, anyone, whether you play rugby or not. So it's going to come soon on Instagram. People should be ready. Yeah. Yeah.
And for you?
For me, I'm a very busy person. I'm a slay queen.
So you say?
I'm a slay queen. I'm a Snapchat queen. So all that follow me on Snapchat, by the way, at Jean Bisela. But anyway, I'm also a student. I'm studying communications in Strathmore. And apart from that, I am a part-time model. Yeah. And the fitness thing. We're starting a fitness company thing together. So, yeah.
Maybe you can give guys your handles, or maybe Team Mafisi, or whatever, whoever, or you might want to keep it to professional. Maybe give just your business handle, whichever.
For now, I think people can just find me at Vicky Gichure, whether it's on Twitter or Facebook or Instagram. Just at Vicky Gichure. Yeah.
At Vicky Gichure. Yeah. And you?
For me, I am everywhere. I can even give you my phone number if you want. But no. You can follow me at Jean Bisela, Snapchat, Facebook, everything. You know how it is out here. Shout out to KCB. Yes.
Jean Bisela.
Jean Bisela. You want me to spell it for you? Because some people don't get it. Yeah. J-E-A-N, then Bisela. B-I-S-E-L-A. Yeah.
Okay, thanks Casey and Jean for talking with us. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Mengi ila ninajua kuna kikomo. Si upendo ni mchezo, uongo si tumeamini. Najaribu kumpenda niliye naye. Go on and let me be. Na and I, mimi sitabaki. Tuajiweka shimo.
Taboo.